Something I noticed on a lot of anxiety forums is people reporting unusual heartbeats. This is not the racing heartbeat that people experience during a panic attack, which is just caused by adrenaline. These are reports of skipped heartbeats, flutters or thuds, and people are unsurprisingly worried about them. Now I should point out that while I'm trained in treating anxiety disorders, I have no medical training whatsoever, so I'm not an expert on the heart. But the reason I decided to make a video on this subject is because I have experienced these same symptoms on and off for the last 14 years. So I'm going to share what I've learned from my own doctor and cardiologist, and also my own experience of ectopic heartbeats. With any abnormal heart rhythm, you should talk to your doctor who can investigate it for you. But what I'm going to talk about in this video is ectopic heartbeats, and try to explain with the help of my usual doodles what they are and why they seem to be quite common in people who suffer from anxiety. Something called the sinus node in the heart creates the electrical signal that makes the heart beat. The sinus is represented here by Sinus Sam beating his drum to a nice regular rhythm. Each time Sinus Sam beats the drum, the heart pumps out blood and then gradually fills up again until the next beat is due, when the heart pumps out the blood again. Sam knows when to beat again because he listens for the echo of his last beat to die down before beating the drum again. Sam is so good at this, you don't even notice your heart beating. With an ectopic heartbeat, an electrical signal comes not from the sinus, but from somewhere else, and it happens prematurely. Depending on where in the heart the ectopic beat originates, it will be called a premature ventricular contraction, PVC, or a premature atrial contraction, PAC. The ectopic beat is represented here by the mischievous Eddie Ectopic with his drum. You may not feel this premature beat because Eddie banged his drum before the heart had a chance to fill up with much blood, so the heart just did a gentle squeeze. You may not have noticed this gentle premature beat, but Sinus Sam has. He is now confused because he thinks it was his drum that made it. He now waits for the echo from ectopic Eddie's drum to die down before beating his drum again. This causes quite a long gap between Sam's beats, and it feels to you like a skipped beat. This pause means the heart has had more time to fill up with blood, so when the heart next beats, it has to be a big strong beat in order to pump out the extra blood. This can feel like a thud in the chest, or can even be felt in the throat where there is a large artery. Depending on how early or late the premature ectopic beat happens, will determine whether you feel a thud or just a flutter. Other symptoms you may notice may be a little cough just after the skip beat, or a sharp intake of breath just for a second. And some people may feel a little bit dizzy, but again, just for a short moment. Don't confuse this with the dizziness you get in a panic attack that lasts much longer. Now this all seems very worrying, but the good news is that pretty much everyone gets ectopic heartbeats, but they just don't notice them, and usually they're not dangerous. They're generally not even treated unless you have a lot of them and they start affecting your quality of life. There are a number of things that can increase the number of ectopics, and this may vary from person to person, but common triggers are alcohol, caffeine, and nicotine. Reducing or eliminating these can really help. I certainly noticed a big improvement in my ectopics when I cut out alcohol and caffeine. But let's get back to anxiety. After all, my channel is an anxiety channel. Why should people with anxiety be prone to ectopics? Ectopic heartbeats are common in people with anxiety for two reasons. One, people with anxiety are very tuned into their body, so may notice ectopic beats that others would not notice. And two, anxiety upsets the autonomic nervous system, which can increase the number of ectopics. So what should you do? Well, first, if you're having a lot of ectopics, get checked out by a doctor. An ECG and echocardiogram will, in the majority of cases, confirm that there is no structural problem with the heart, and they are just harmless ectopics. These tests are pretty conclusive, so if the doctor tells you that there is nothing to be concerned about, then it's important to accept it. If you're a subscriber to my channel, you will know that reassurance seeking fuels anxiety. So, if after being given the all clear, you keep seeking reassurance through Google or social media, not only will you make your anxiety worse, you may actually increase the frequency of the ectopics. If you would like to know more about ectopics, I highly recommend watching Sanjay Gupta of York Cardiology on YouTube. Sanjay is a great cardiologist who is also very sympathetic and understanding of people with anxiety. And if you want to know more about anxiety, make sure you subscribe to my channel and please like and share my video.